It's quiet at the moment, but I have a feeling there's something in the air.
As the ITER project is entering its fourth summer, the skyline in Cadarache is about to change. Just over the fence from ITER headquarters, preparatory works are in full gear for the digging and pouring of concrete. The contracts for construction of the coil winding facility and the tokamak excavation have been signed, and now it's time to get the shovels out. A brand new temporary office building is nearing completion that will provide additional office space for ITER staff and house the architect-engineer team that will assist the European Domestic Agency with the construction of the ITER facilities. Currently, IT is putting the final touches on the computer network infrastructure to have everything in place when the new residents move in. As we prepare for action here in Cadarache, far across the seas, manufacturing is in full swing for ITER. The fabrication of superconducting strands for ITER's magnet system is well underway in Korea. In Japan, superconductors are undergoing their first leak testing trials. The team in India is testing the first components for ITER's heating systems, and in China, the correction coils that will help fine-tune ITER's plasma behavior are being produced. Recently, the ITER newsline reported on the first components to take to the seas, when in March, dummy conductors and superconductors were shipped from their production facility in Japan to a facility for testing. This is only the beginning of the excitement, so stay tuned.